Evening folks, this is Best in Slot and welcome back to a little bit more Planet Zoo. Now, the new Arctic DLC may have added 4 animals and over 200 construction pieces, but what it also did was expand the campaign. Well, there's like a new side campaign basically called Arctic Adventures. We have not finished the main campaign, we've really been taking our time. That's something we're still doing over time very slowly here on the channel, you know, gold starring and having fun with each park. We're definitely going to carry on with that, you know, we're working on that dig site one at the moment, the quarry in Brazil. But to celebrate the release of the DLC, we're going to sidetrack ourselves a little bit and get through the Arctic Adventures DLC first. So, definite Arctic cool. There's a pun there, but I don't know what it is. Goodwin Arctic Research Park. Situated near a small Norwegian fishing village, this site was chosen by Bernie Goodwin for the purpose of building an Arctic wildlife research zoo, the likes of which the world has never seen. The last time Bernie was here, he got himself lost and declared legally dead. So keep your fingers crossed that you do better. In gloves, obviously. Nobody likes frostbite. And there's our brand new reindeer. So this is where Bernie was working when he disappeared. Let's get started.
Ah, can you smell that fresh Norwegian air? Mm-mm. It's good to be back here. So many memories. Many of them good. Now, this zoo is the first of 2 new ventures, which will specialize in Arctic animals. Although I'm sure that was fairly obvious from the temperature. I didn't choose this location just because I love lutefisk. This particular site will be focusing on researching, breeding, and releasing all sorts of animals from the far north. And I'm hoping that research will help us find out just what it'll take for us to preserve these species in the face of global warming. Remember, we're not trying to make a massive profit here. We're trying to make a difference. That said, you're going to be dealing with reindeer, Arctic wolves, even polar bears. And that means expanding the zoo a lot. So, some profit would definitely be useful.
Okay, well, this zoo is awesome. Okay, I'm just gonna, like, I know, like, people are gonna comment on this. If you know what goes on in the story of Planet Zoo, please keep it out of the comments. I do think this has spoiled it a little bit. I'm gonna invent my old headcanon here, okay? So, let's pretend, ignore the little hints suggesting otherwise, let's pretend that what's happening here is when Bernie first goes off to the Arctic, you know, before we even meet Myers in the main Planet Zoo campaign, Bernie has invited us along. This is an alternate timeline. We go with Bernie to the Arctic to help him set up his research stations, and that's what we're playing through here. Okay? Roll with me on this one. Right. So here we are. Let's take a... This is absolutely awesome. I love this central display. These new trees with the... actually, they're not even them. Oh, that's so cool. The new trees with the baubles on these ones, I actually love the, like, ready-made Christmas trees that count as foliage. And look at this. What is this? Is this just wood? That's just wooden path covered in snow. It's really cool. We've got the new ice rocks here at the side. Head down here, that's the entrance over there. A couple of... that's just stuff to make it look more like a research station. Right, so what are our goals? Let's pause things up once more. Check over here. So, adopt and place 10 reindeer. It seems that we have been given those already. Increase their welfare to 80%. Have at least 3 habitat species, so the reindeer and something else. And then we need to research the reindeer. So... what's this here? That is our beloved, my beloved, beloved Daal Sheep. I love these things so much. You will not believe how much I love these things. What have we got over here? These are staff buildings. Yep, those are our staff buildings in this kind of built into the snow. That is very, what's this? Is this snow rock? They've built them into the snow using the snow rock. That's very cool. So I'm excited. We've got more staff buildings down here. This looks like a really good spot for the reindeer, doesn't it? I think that's kind of ready-made. I don't think there's anywhere else laying out, so we'll do it here. That makes a lot of sense, and we'll try to use the same materials they're using. So we're going to use the steel mesh, and let's get started. So hit play, why not, live the dream. So barriers, give me some lovely steel mesh. Are you curvy? You're not. Are you curvy though? See, you're curvy. You've cleared. Wait, are you? No, you're not curvy. You're not curvy. I won't be curvy. Solidarity, sister. Solidarity. I'm gonna leave the rocks out. They're a nice little... ooh, crikey. They're a nice little viewing thing. So, yeah, we're just gonna bring this in. bring this round to the back, and then cut it along there a little bit. Now, I'm going to make this a decent size, but I would like to put another exhibit right here, just because it does say we need 3 habitat species. And of course, we only have 2 once this reindeer is done. So, we're going to bring this up now. And I think we could... Actually, might bring it up a little bit sooner than that. And I think the reindeer will be very happy in this space, but we can also then hopefully bring in another species in a little bit. That's plenty of room. Absolutely... But loads of room. Cool. What's this? Staff area. I love these torches. These make me incomprehensibly happy. I have a thing for fire. Like in a, no, in a good way. Not in a, arsonist kind of way. But in a more like a arsonist kind of, no, I really like fire, you know? That kind of thing speaks to me on a deep aesthetic level. Anywho, animal trading. We should have many, yes, thousands upon thousands of reindeer. Into our animal storage, just grab them, select all, and move. 1 buck male and his harem, essentially. Right, so they're going to be on the way. Let's try to get this set up at least a little bit. Species. I wonder, I'm curious, is it going to stay dark forever? Also, can we see the Aurora Borealis? We can't, that's a shame. I'm just wondering, because, you know, the Arctic often has nights that last for months, essentially. And then you'll get like 6 months of darkness, and then you'll get 6 months of permanent light. It's very funky. So I'm wondering if that's something we'll see integrated. That'd be very cool if so. There we go. Get me a food trough. Can I get 2? Because we'd have a few of them, and a couple of water pipes as well. I am still a little sick. Excuse me. Okie dokie. How happy are we? How are we feeling? How are you living? Yeah, plenty. I really don't need much room at all. We are going to have to get them some shelter. This is all fine. We'll give them a little environment as well. Enrichment we can't do yet, but what we can do is assign our vet research. Keith is going to learn all about the reindeer. He's a good man, Keith. Trust him with my life. Keith, where are you? Keith? Kathy, I'm so sorry. I don't know why I read Keith. Kathy, she's a good lass. Salt of the earth, I'm telling you. So sorry, Kathy, I really am. The one problem with this exhibit is the guests are quite far away. Also, we need some donation boxes. Come here. Oh, look, they've even got like a little Arctic colour scheme. Like, Frontier have added the colour scheme in. That's very cool. If the video jumps every now and again, I do apologise. I'm still fairly ill, and I'm trying to cut out like the big coughing fits, essentially. But I'll do my best to just not cough, essentially. Right, so I think what I want to do... they're not using that, are they? Oh, God, what's going on here? What are they using? They're using this. Yeah, so I'll use the same. That's not going to work. All right, game, I get it. I'm not trying to do it anymore. I'm sorry. I just want to try to get people nearer to the deer if possible. Yeah, that'll do. That'll blimmin' do. How are we living? We're gonna be fine. We're gonna be fine. Right, so the enrichment is on the way. Give them some hard shelter. Unfortunately, we don't have the fancy new ones, but we could build a fancy new one, in theory. I don't see why not, right? Let's go just Arctic pack. Let's see what we can do. We're not gonna go over the board here, because in this campaign, we tend to be fairly chill, but I don't see why not. Where's my construction items? Where's my wall? I'm gonna build a wall. It's gonna be a nice wall though, not a mean wall. Okay, there we go. Look at that. It's beautiful. Oh, that's an absolute masterpiece. Oof. Okay, and then we're gonna. Where's that? Where are those fragments? Do I want those on? What if I put them there and then sink them in? Does that look cool? Does that look stupid? That looks stupid. I'm really not good at like just thinking up things off the top of my head. This is not where my abilities lie. I'm thinking I'm gonna make it small. I'm gonna make like a little baby one instead, I've decided. That'll be cute. Okay. You're a bad wall now. You get tiny baby huts. Only tiny baby huts allowed. I mean, that is a masterpiece. I think we can all agree. How we feeling, dear? How we feeling? We're feeling good, actually, as it happens. We're feeling pretty good. Nope, we're feeling 1%. Okay, never mind. I regret all of my words. What if I double this up? Right, we're going to extend it. Okay, okay. The reindeer have spoken. We need to do something whilst we're waiting for them to pop in anyway. We're going to extend this double. Get rid of that. Wonder if that counts. I wonder if that doesn't count as a roof, interestingly enough. Oh, I'm just going to go back to making it humongous. It is snowing, it's a bit brisk out. Oh, it is daytime. Oh, it's really cute. I prefer it at nighttime, but it's really cute. Let's move you over to the corner, you big leviathan that you are. I just want to put a roof on. We'll work on some details later. Right now, we just need to blimmin' roof. I need to spend a little more time with this. Where's my wood at? Oh, hello. Ooh, interesting. Got a little plan for me, right, so I'm going to put this in. Nope, not 1 meter, I want flat. Where's my flatty? Oh yeah, there you are. Okay, and over there. And then we're going to grab our lovely roof that I just saw.
You know, when our animal rescue unit told me to expect reindeer, I was confused why, one, they were talking about the weather, and two, they were being so familiar. Reindeer? No. Oh well. Good work getting him settled in anyway.
It looks like a McDonald's building. Oh, Bernie, I did miss you in your awful, awful puns. I really did. This is going to look terrible. I'm just going to do it anyway. It's the world we live in now. I don't know if it makes sense. I'm dying. You got to be nice to me. I'm dead. Yes, I've made a thing. Are you happier now, at least? As long as you're happy, I don't... Oh, you're injured. Let's get you a vet, buddy. Also, how is our research going? Is we still not? Huh. Kathy? Kathy? Where are you, idiot? You're not bringing your A-game, are you? Kathy is disappointing me a little bit here. Well, their welfare should be fine. It should. It's not there yet, but it will be. As soon as we get the enrichment in, they're going to be hunky-dory. Hard shelter is actually high enough now with my incredible building. So we're just kind of waiting on Kathy to do her job a little bit. Knowing Kathy will be here for bloody ages, so we'll do some nature in the meantime. Let's go to North America and I want to talk about this briefly. I mentioned in my last video that caribou and reindeer are essentially the same thing, and that North America say caribou, and here in England or Britain or Europe we say reindeer, right? And I had a few people try to correct me. I'm just going to point something out, because these reindeer are, you know, continents, North America and Europe. So basically, caribou and reindeer are the same species, and as somebody else pointed out very helpfully in the comments, different subspecies of the same species. They are the exact same species type, but slightly different subspecies. They're essentially the same animal anyway. But in this game, they're from North America and Europe, so they're exactly the same thing. There's no subspecies at play here. Caribou and reindeer are interchangeable. If you say caribou, you're probably North American. If you're saying reindeer, you're probably... Eurasian, that's all. I think it's interesting that we pronounce this animal completely differently despite, you know, the similarities. Very interesting. Where's my big tree? Yes, this one. This is the one. This is the only tree I ever want to play with ever again. Not even joking. I love it so much. Festive spruce. What's that from? Spruce. I have no idea. It's not going to look that impressive at night and day, but you wait till nighttime, buddy boy. It's going to be amazing. Gonna get my vines on a little bit. Stick some of those on there. Very cool. I never got to play with ivy. It's getting there. It doesn't look like a building. It looks like a weird hut. Box. Looks like a cardboard box. What if I put some foliage around it? Will that help? Or make it much worse? If we don't even pretend that it's meant to be a building, will I feel better about it? God, everything looks so much nicer in the snow. I'm really excited to build an alpine park. Do-do-do-do-do-do. I think if you stick some windows on there, we can turn that into something. Maybe. It looks a little daft if you stare too long at it, but that's fine. Everything does. Myself included. These are reindeer. Let's check them out. In case you missed my little video on the DLC earlier, there they are. Our reindeer. Caradia, Rainabu, I don't know what you want to call them. I'm going to call them reindeer. Looking absolutely lovely. Mostly females. We do have a little bit of a stud. Oh, look at that. That is gorgeous. The lighting of this game is actually incredible. the way the light is backlight like that, you know, and how it catches in the fur. When they take screenshots off this game, you know, for promo materials, it often looks faked because it's such a good effect. But look at it. It's genuine. It's actually in the game. It's amazing. It actually blows me away every time. It's one of the... It's one of the best backlight effects I've ever seen in a video game, if not the best. Genuinely, one of the best I've ever seen. I mean, it's incredible. They're lighting up. Anyways, what are we waiting on? What's going on here? Yeah, they're not going to be happy until this is done, and I can't do that yet, so... What we can do in the meantime is we can ramp up our education a little bit. Find a education stand. Keep it nice and simple for now. Oop. Okay, that's back to fun. Sweet. Okay, let's... Never mind. It's hard to tell because it turns on the heat map and you can't see. put one there. Education is actually pretty easy to do. You just... Honestly, you just... What you essentially do is stick stuff everywhere. That's really all it takes. Although it does take a lot of it. I'll say the education is one of those ratings that takes a very long time to climb. Oh, we can even use these. These are really cool, actually. I really like these ones. These are the Arctic Zoopedia frames. And they're perfect. Look at them. They're gorgeous. Bam! Look at that sexy little so-and-so. I'm going to move the bench. Sexy little so-and-so is impeding on it slightly. With its sexiness. There we go. First time we've called a Zoopedia frame sexy, but first time for everything, folks. Gotta make it sexy. Okay, that'll help our education rating a bit. Really, all I need to do is get this blooming research done. And it's not happening, I think, because our vet has too much work to do. So, we're going to help them out. We're going to hire two more vets. Okay. I'm going to train. Kathy, didn't I train you? I'm going to train you again, Kathy. One day, Kathy will get to work. I'm going to be so proud of her when she does. One day she'll get to work. But she's been told to work. Everyone else has been told to look after the animals now. So, hopefully, that's a thing. Now. Look at that. Isn't that so cool? I love that environment in the distance. It's gorgeous. Anywhoozle. Oh, they're like igloos. All lit up. Sorry, I'm excited about everything. I'm a deer. Oh, you need trees. That'll be the third part of this video I cut out. Everybody needs trees, right? I'm going to give you... Where are you? No, where? Where's my nice ones? Every tree is a Christmas tree. Every single tree. We could theme them with different colours. Like, this is nice, but maybe we want to mix things up a little bit. Bam! Maybe the Daal Deer are working with the Sith. You never know, folks. It's hard to predict these kind of things. I actually really like the yellow. I think that looks great. I just think they're so cool. I don't know why. It's because I have an obsession with trees and I have an obsession with lights, actually. What they've done, what Frontier have basically done, is combine my two favourite things in Planet Zoo. If you stick a hippo on it somewhere, I'm done. Like, this is... the pinnacle of my life, right? I love that so much. I can't get over it. I really can't. We don't have any shops, do we? I guess that's set up for a shop right there. Oh, there. We're set up for plenty of shops. We don't need it right now. But, oh, they're going in together. That's nice. It's nice when couples do everything together. You know, urination. Why not? Live the dream. This is actually a really nice little exhibit. It's very... Oh, yes! Yes! I see research! Exciting! Nice! Come on, Kathy. You're better than this, girl. You're better than this. We're all better than this. I'm going to speed up time now. I'm hoping Kathy is... I'm hoping we're going to see some movement here. What we should be doing in the meantime, I should say. We need three habitat species. Let me think. We're going to get wolves. We're going to get polar bears. How am I going to fit everything? Right, so we need like a little habitat species that we can put in this little gap here. So, let's have a look at animal trading. Timberwolf isn't a bad bet. It's an animal that could possibly live here. Snow leopard, good bet, but I don't have the cash. I guess they're only giving me viable animals anyway. Grizzly bear. Oh, the Daal Sheep. Oh, the Arctic Wolf. Well, we don't need the Arctic Wolf. The bison. Eh, I'm not feeling the bison. It's funny, the bison in real life wouldn't mind living in the cold, but actually in this game, if you let them run around in the snow, they'll get upset. I think we're going to go for a grizzly bear pair. Because they're cheap and cheerful. There we go. Emberlyn, which is a beautiful name, and Willoughby. I said I was going to do something, you know, nice and simple, and I picked grizzly bears, but Whatever. Steel mesh, climbable, but we can fix that. Not a problem. One little complaint I want to point out there. So what I want to do right now is go from this little fence post over here, connect all this together, and make this into the grizzly bear exhibit, right? I actually can't. I can't click here and then go anywhere else because it's part of a habitat. What you have to do is click here and then come across. That's the only way to do it. It's not like the end of the world. It just, it's something that I think could be better, essentially. That's all. I see it's same there. Don't want to go too far out. People need to be able to see what's going on. I should, in theory, if we connect all this down the back onto there, I think that'll be plenty of room for a couple of grizzlies. So, let's grab our path. That's going to go right across the front like so. Make sure our humans can actually see the animals this time. Probably a good idea. Let's stick our barrier on there. It's so pretty. What have they done with all these trees? All these trees here are lit up, but how? Is it just because of this one? No. Are you being lit? Where have they hid the lights? Ah, cheeky. Is it this? Yeah, there must be a couple of spotlights hidden under the ground and in different areas to make the trees kind of glow, but not all with baubles. It's like a Christmas wonderland. I love Christmas, by the way. Like, in case that wasn't immediately obvious, I'm like a huge fan of Christmas. I don't know why, it's just, I like cheesy things. That's not going to work. I like cheesy things, and I like, you know, daft family sentimentality and all this kind of rubbish. Mock me though you might. Christmas is awesome. And I say that as someone who really did not have a strong family ethic growing up at all. Like, believe me. I'll do a draw of my life one day. Anywho, so. Can we put this on both of them together? Yeah, there we go. Climb proof. Should be fine. Looks a little bit imposing and spooky, but that's okay. I'm an imposing and spooky kind of guy. You can still see it, perfectly fine. I might raise this up so we can stand on mountains. Just so at the moment, it kind of doesn't look like you'd actually be able to see into the exhibit, so if we make that a lot bigger, that makes more sense. Can we bring this down now? Yeah, look at that. Know my way around this game like a hedgehog knows its way around a bush. That's literally the best metaphor I could come up with on short notice. How are we doing over here? Oh, nice.
It's wonderful to see some new species around here. Some of the guests are practically shaking with excitement. Well, it's either that or the cold.
Okay. See, terrain, they're actually still happy. Environment is the problem. So, let's get some happy bears. North America, so let's go to Europe. And we're looking for tundra, taiga, and actually temperate as well. Biome. Temperate. Theme? No, not theme. Content pack? Yeah? Yeah! There we go! Don't judge me. I love them, okay? This is what all I've ever wanted. It's literally my favourite things. Just let me have this. Although it's doing very little for my coverage, so I think we'll probably have to get rid of that. And add some other stuff to spruce it up a little bit. Actually, tell you what we should do first. Get them some food. Angry Grizzly Bear seems like a very bad idea. So, grizzlies would love a food tray. And this thing. Oh, we're gonna get some baby dolls! Awesome! We'll just do a little Planet Zoo shelter for now. I say little. We'll just do a humongous Planet Zoo. I'm gonna move that tree. Go, guys! Enjoy! Now we just need a little bit more nature, and we should. Okay, we need quite a lot more nature. We should be good. I don't really want to put big trees in, because I already have big trees. Put some little cypress in. Even a bigger cypress. Okay, I'm crazy. Some Dutchman's breeches, yes. My favourite kinds of breeches. Look, I've had breeches from many different countries in my time. I will say the Dutchman's were my favourite of the breeches. It's been a long day. I was actually designing an exhibit just like this very recently for my grizzly bears, actually, as it happens, on my franchise zoo. So I kind of know exactly what I want. I'm looking for it. There it is, white sagebrush. White sage bloody bush. It's so good. You just sink it in. It's like little sprouting, interesting grasses. It just makes the ground look so much more appealing than it ever did. And I know I'm sinking bushes into the ground like a bloody addict, but this is what the world looks like, you know? The world looks like it has interesting grasses and different textures. It's not homogenous. It's varied and oofity. You know what I mean? Oofity. It's a direct quote. I'm going to put some of these big boys in as well. Because they don't impede on my beloved. We're getting there. We're on the cusp of greatness. Honestly, everything looks better in the snow. I'm actually really excited to build on this map. Even half and half like that. Awesome. I've never built on a snow map before. It's exciting to me. There we go. That looks really nice. Pleasant. How are we doing? Are we happy little burr? I think we're over than the enrichment, which we can sort of fix-ish. Does this count? Nope. Look, I'll get someone on that. Oh, there we go. Good stuff. Let's get you on the grizzly bear. Did we have our baby? I want my baby. Yes, there we go, baby. The babies. Who's the baby? Oh, is that bad? Sorry. I got it. It's so cute! And the noises! Honestly, like, one of my top five animals in a... I already said this, but... I don't know why I love them so much. I really don't. You'd think sheep would be, like, the least interesting animal in the game, but... they do it for me. In a normal way, not in a... Not in a weird way. He's gonna eat. Oh, he's fascinated by the bauble is actually like a flat circle. That's interesting. He loves it. He's like been guided by this weird orb that's gonna lead him on his life quest. I want to get you guys some enrichment. Actually, I think the enrichment for the reindeer, which we're about to do, will also count for the doll, I think. If I had to guess. Let's have a look. What do we get? We've got a barrel feeder. Should help. Two barrel feeders? Sweet. There we go. Just gotta get that up to two. And we need a lot more education. We can do that. So, we're gonna gold star, we're gonna bronze star. And we're gonna get some bebbers. Bebbers. Okay, so, first things first. Donation box over here. Let's get more of these lovely boys. So let's just make a few signs and then we'll stick up some educational speakers. And what I'll do is I'll stick down some conservation signs as well. Those tend to do the trick pretty well. I don't really want to cover that up. Maybe we just put screen in this time, just because it's a big fence, you know? There you go. Learn all about the burrs. People love the burrs. Loving it. You guys gonna be, let's see, let's do a little experiment here, shall we? We're gonna click that, bam. We're gonna click that, bam. There we go, we got one, that's not bad. Right. I'm hype about this DLC, I really am. Like, I know some people are a bit iffy about the whole concept, but me, I'm just happy to get more Planet Zoo, really. My only problem is, there's so much going on right now that I keep neglecting everything else. Like, Jeepock Park has been so badly neglected, but... At the end of the day, this kind of takes priority for me right now. We've all got to go in. Nice. Bam. The only problem I have with this, it's very large. It's very dramatic, isn't it? But people are loving it. Look, I'm chucking that money down. Having the time of their lives. Okay. Let's try to get some educational speakers on the go. Edu. There we go. So I'm just going to put this one there. Quite a nice little place for it, actually. Grizzly can go to there. Already got one over here, apparently. Grab this one, put that there. Be reindeer. Bring that down. Something like that. Oh, no. Keeper. How many keepers do I have? Do I only have one? Yeah, we need another. The zoo isn't very big, so I don't think we need to worry about, you know, work zones and stuff. There's three exhibits and they're all really close to the staff area, anyway. You know what I should have done? I should have done an Arctic wolf exhibit as the third exhibit, now that I'm thinking about it. Because then I could just put more wolves in, and we'd have done the challenge. But whatever. Oh, there's a speaker there. Huh. Why is that so huge? Why has that got the biggest range of anything in human history? I have no idea, but we're going to bring it down, so we can bring the reindeer up a little bit at least. Shuffle that way. There we go. Okay. Now, clearly we haven't hit... We're still 1.1. It hasn't actually gone up at all. Now, I think partially that's because it actually takes a long time to go up. You know, your guests need to walk around the park. But what we're going to do, we're going to boost that up right up. We're going to put some of these in. These are really cool for this. So we're just going to put that there. Ah, please stop doing that automatically. Pretty please. I know, I can just hit N. Wait, is it N? H. There we go, I can just hit H. I have to hit it twice for some reason. H. Okay, who wants to learn some science about the amphibs? About the bees. Everyone needs to learn about the bees. And about population fragmentation. I love population fragmentation. I don't love population fragmentation. I love learning about population fragmentation. I also love saying the words, population fragmentation. Whenever I start a band, as all people on this planet have once said, we should start a band. Or open a bar. It's going to be called Population Defragmentation. I don't think that's a bad band name. Or just Defragmentation. That's probably already taken. That's quite emo. Some really nice music coming out of this. Look at that. Isn't that adorable? Is this new? I've never seen this before. The music speaker. Yes. Amazing. Right, okay. Love it. I'm just going to put a few more of these down, I guess. Everyone must learn about the frogs. Nothing matters but the frogs. And poaching. And oh, such a depressing thing to do here. Poaching and the ozone layer. There we go. Have we climbed at all? 1.2. Right, so if I put the game on super speed, we should, in theory, get our... Yeah, vet research is actually done.
You know, I am always amazed by the research work our vets do. They're discovering so much critical information which will really help with breeding reindeer. Huh, puts me to shame anyway. Huh, I can't even remember the names of Santa's ones.
Is it all Cadeny? There we go! See what I mean? You just have to give it a little bit of time.
Good work on making such outstanding progress. I'll be honest. I was worried about the viability of building a zoo in this location, but you've completely vindicated my decision. You know, if it wasn't for the whole accidentally going missing and being declared dead part of founding the zoo, I'd call it a complete success.
Bernie, buddy, you are ruining my headcanon. Look, right, okay, so I think we can... say, yeah, I'm very sorry to announce, Bernie does in fact survive. That's actually really cool, right? That's awesome. He doesn't die, he goes missing. He is, assumedly, I actually don't know the context of how it works. I don't know the storyline for the Planet Zoo campaign, but I did find out that Bernie comes back. And that's a bit of a shame that we've been spoiled, but admittedly, I don't really play Planet Zoo to avoid story spoilers, so I'm not that bothered about it. It's cool that he's alive. It's cool that we're helping him here in the Arctic. It's less cool that he's ruining my headcanon. God damn it, Bernie. Right then. What's going on here? Yeah, that is our call that. That is our Arctic Wolves. Tapisa and Tulimak. We'll be playing with those in the next video. We're going to place both of those, get them happy, get more education. You'll see that. That'll climb. That'll nearly hit 2.5 without me doing anything at this point. 6 habitat species. Wow. I wonder if Arctic Wolves and Timber Wolves can live together. Huh, I'm going to breed some animals as well. That won't be a problem. Right then. So, God knows where we're going to put them. Like, no idea. I guess there's a little path. Oh, yeah. I mean, room for absolute days over here. So, not a problem at all. Next video then, folks. We will get our Arctic wolves in and get some more animals as well. Don't know what they'll be, but they'll be something cool. cool things are cool. Thank you so much for joining me. I'm not sure right now if we're going to keep doing the normal Planet Zoo campaign as well as this campaign, or if we're just going to sidetrack for a little bit and work on this one. I'll have to have a think. It depends on like how the schedule fits. I would like to go back to Jurassic World Evolution someday. But until then, we're going to have some fun with this. I'm really excited to play with all the new construction items and all the new animals and see Bernie again. It's all really cool stuff. Until that next time, thank you so much for joining me. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.